The U.S. reportedly preparing a new weapons package for Ukraine. Three U.S. officials told Reuters the $275 million military package will include artillery shells, aerial munitions, and ground vehicles. This comes as Kyiv struggles to hold off Moscow's forces, which have launched a ground assault into the north. The U.S. officials said the weapons aid could be announced as soon as Friday. Last month, Biden signed into law nearly $61 billion worth of various aid for Ukraine. At least 22 people have died in Mexico due to heat-related causes. That death toll was recorded between May 12 and 21 as a weather phenomenon called heat dome sweeps across the country. This heat dome traps hot air, creating record-breaking temperatures as high as 45 degrees Celsius. Relief is not yet in the horizon as forecasters warn Mexico could experience its hottest temperatures on record in the coming weeks. Over in Brazil, heavy rains again pound its southernmost state of Rio Grande do Sul, ruining cleanup efforts there. Rains had lightened up to a drizzle over the past few days as residents tried to rebuild after widespread flooding. But heavy downpours again flooded several areas Thursday. Record flooding in Brazil over the past month has killed at least 163 people and displaced 600,000 others. Another 64 people are still missing. Four people are dead and at least 21 others injured after a building collapsed in the Spanish island of Mallorca. The two-story building housed a restaurant and is located near a beach. Local media report people were dancing on a terrace that collapsed on top of another floor underneath. No word yet on the cause of the collapse. Earplugs highly advised as cicadas begin to emerge throughout the southern and midwestern United States. Billions of the buzzing insects are expected thanks to a double brood where 13-year and 17-year cicadas emerge at the same time. The rare occurrence has not been seen in centuries. The epicenter for this cacophony of noise, parts of Illinois, which serve as a cross-section for the two broods that have spent years living underground before surfacing to briefly mate and die. The last time the two breeds emerged together was in 1803 when Thomas Jefferson was president of the U.S., and the next will be in 2245. Moro National Liberation Front Chairman Nur Miswati convicted on two counts of graft by the Sandigan buy-in. Let's get details now from our correspondent Sherianne Torres. Sherianne, go ahead.
Yes, Carmina, Moro National Liberation Front Chairman Nur Miswati was convicted for two counts of graft by the Sandigan Bayan. Miswati's case stemmed from the alleged anomalous purchase of educational materials by the Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao when he was still the governor. Miswati and his co-accused, however, were acquitted on two counts of malversation of public funds through falsification of public documents. The others in the case are Leo Vigilda Sinches, Pangalian Maniri, Sita Aiza Usman, Aladdin Usi, Nader Makagaan, and Cristeta Ramirez. The cases stemmed from the 31 million peso worth of acquired educational materials, which Miswati approved on December 21, 2000 as then governor of ARM. A similar transaction dated July 24, 2001 was also approved by Miswati, amounting to 46.251 billion pesos. The allegation also stated that Miswati and six others falsified public documents such as requisition and issue voucher, purchase order, sales invoice, and disbursement accounts and payables. In Friday's promulgation of the case against Miswati et al., the Sandigan Bayan 3rd Division, chaired by Presiding Justice Amparo Cabotaje Tang, the court finds the MNLF chairman guilty of two counts of violation or violating the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Each count is equivalent to 6 years and 1 month to 8 years of imprisonment. However, the court finds that Miswati and others are acquitted of malversation through falsification due to the prosecution's failure to prove their guilt beyond reasonable doubt. Carmina, the 85-year-old Miswati attended the court promulgation virtually and was represented by his lawyer, Maria Victoria Lim Florido. The MNLF chairman's daughter, Nor Aimee Tan, meanwhile, personally attended the proceedings. According to Lim Florido, They are very thankful that the court was able to appreciate all their presented evidence to prove her client's innocence on the malversation of public funds. The acquittal on the malversation of public funds case, she said, is the most important, given that that is actually the root cause of the graft charges against Ms. Wari. And they said, and she said that they are going to appeal the case. The same goes for the other accused in the said case. Ms. Wari and others are allowed to post bail pending the final resolution of the case. But the bond of 30,000, which they gave earlier during the early part of the hearing of the case, was doubled or ordered double by the Sandigan Bayan. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Sherry Ann Torres there joining us on the line.